Good morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God's grace and peace be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. Let's take a moment as we remember that God is always merciful, presenting our sins to Him and receiving that gift of mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord
Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh. You are the splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of all of our sins, and bring us into everlasting. May the working of your mercy, O Lord, we pray, direct our hearts aright. For without your grace, we cannot find favor in your sight. We pray this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Some in the crowd who heard these words of Jesus said, truly the prophet. Others said, this is the Christ. But others said, the Christ will not come from Galilee, will he? Does not the scripture say that the Christ will be of David's family and come from Bethlehem, the village where David lived? So a division occurred in the crowd because of him. Some of them even wanted to arrest him, but no one laid hands on him. So the guards went to the chief priests and Pharisees, who asked them, why did you not bring him? Guards answered, never before has anyone spoken like this man. So the Pharisees answered them, have you also been deceived? Have any of the authorities or the Pharisees believed in him? But this crowd, which does not know the law, is accursed. Nicodemus, one of their members, who had come to him earlier, said to them, does our law condemn a man before it first hears him or finds out what he is doing? They answered and said to him, you are not from Galilee also, are you? Look and see that no prophet arises from Galilee. Then each went to his own home. The Gospel of the Lord. The pattern continues this morning in the scriptures as we listen to one of the prophets today, Jeremiah, responding to the call that God has given to him and experiencing the backlash of speaking the truth for God. Jeremiah today is the prefigurement of Jesus. He shows us in the Old Testament what Jesus will be like. One of the lines from Jeremiah this morning asks the question to us, as Jeremiah says, for to you I have entrusted my cause. It's another way of saying Jeremiah has experienced all of this onslaught of evil, but he still chooses to trust in God. For to you I have entrusted my cause. So today we're asked to live only this day. And the question for us from the scriptures this morning is, no matter what we experience in the midst of this very strange way of living right now, the question to us is, have we entrusted our cause today to God? Our cause should be very focused, very single-hearted. No matter what the circumstance or situation, we have been asked to love. Love without cost, love without condition, love without end. That is our cause today. If we take it on our own, we may not know how we can do that. Today may feel like it's just too much to do in love. And that's why it's important to entrust our cause to Him. Good and loving God, we pray this morning for our church, for our leaders, for all of us as members, that we might continue to remember today the cause that God has given to us to be His presence on the earth. So God, we ask you to give us the courage and the humility to be your presence in whatever circumstance, whatever situation. for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer to you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice might be found acceptable to God, who is Almighty.
And the Lord is the sacrifice of your name, and the praise and glory of his name, probably in the law of the Holy Church.
Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, with these oblations you receive from our hands, and even when our wills are deficient, constrain them mercifully to turn to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given us, your children, this sacred time, for the renewing and purifying of our hearts, that freed from disordered affections, we may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that endure forever. And so, with the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Archbishop, and all of your clergy and people.
Jesus, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace is my gift to you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord Jesus be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. How blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May your holy gifts purify us, O Lord, and by their working render us more pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you all for joining in prayer this morning from wherever you are. We pray God's blessing, so please open your hearts, bow your heads, and pray for that blessing. Look upon your people, O Lord, and as they draw near to the coming festivities, bestow upon them abundance of heavenly grace, that helped by the consolations of this world, they may be impelled more readily towards the higher goods that cannot be seen, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God continue to bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now in the